everybody. So first, this is an unrinsed fabric.
Right.
Right, the samples that we received from...
Yes, from Millikan.
From Millikan. And we're going to test DMF, ethanol, and methanol.
Ethyl ether. Yes.
Ethyl ether. All right. All right. I have the lighter. You have the pipettes. We're going to test first for...
Discard beacon
recommends.
We're going to test whether or not we get breakthrough. And then we're going to test if we get flameage. Uh-oh.
Running off a little bit.
So by removing the flame, it didn't self-extinguish.
Well, we still have fuel.
Mm-hmm. There is that.
It's still on. Turn off the light again.
Kill the light.
It's still burning.
It's still burning.
No, it's done now.
Fascinating.
Fabric is still intact.
Looks like fabric is still intact, but I don't know if...
More see-through
than anything else. Alrighty. Three more?
Images.
Yeah.
We'll need a director of the agent.
So, which one is washed and which one is not?
This one is unwashed, and this one is pre-soaked in acetone.
Pre-soaked in acetone. Okay, so what are we doing here? Are we... Josh is bringing some acetic acid over. Okay. Alright, the honors. Which is which?
Left is normal, right is pre-wash with plastic.
Oh, that's pretty quick.
So both soaked straight through?
Yeah, this one went more through, that one went more out.
And then through.
And then through.
Liquid in the bottom of our beaker. Here. Do we want to try to catch it on fire?
It's like glacial acetic acid, only much more so.
Notice how Amelia has changed her lab coat from a Nomex lab coat to a cotton lab coat. She's working with a strong
straight through. Oh, no, it's smoky.
Is it smoking?
The right hand one.
Smoky.
It is starting to discolor a little bit.
Can you see it smoke?
Oh, yeah.
Just the faintest.
So the one on the right is the one that was that was pre-treated.
Yes.
Soaked in acid. You did see the TFA smoke, though.
Oh, and that one just went through.
But the one treated with acetone.
Give it a minute.
It's starting.
And now it's dripping through. It's got a little bit of a delay while it eats the coating.
Well, no, the one on the right was already pre-treated with acetone.
Right, I think the pyridine is eating the coating. We can test flammability if we wish. I imagine it's going to go right through. Oh, or not.
Go for it.
The next one is boron tribromide.
I'm sorry?
Boron tribromide.
Okay.
So nice. Water reactive.
Okay, we'll do that.
And then we'll do aquaregia.
Yes, boron tribromide.
You want to do this?
I don't actually.
That's good.
Pretty typical.
Yeah, it's very.
You're accustomed to seeing that when you're with it.
Yeah, it's always very, it's very angry. I call it very angry. Very good job.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's in DCM, so it's probably not.
DCM, no.
So it's
definitely discoloring.
Is the reagent dissolved in DCM? Discolor.
Keep going a little.
Alrighty, I'll keep going a little. See if we can cause it to fail.
Nice.
Yeah.
It's good and crispy.
Well, that was fun.
Is that treated or untreated?
It's untreated. Okay, who's next?
Which is this one.
That is...
Those are for the upper region.
That's for the upper region. Okay. Don't mess with the system there. Okay, Karen.
No, it's already on.
Yeah.
It's already on.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Oh,
wow.
Oh. Look at that.
All right.
That's already broken
stuff
through.
Yeah, that's...
Mm-hmm.
That was just acetone.
That's gone. Ooh. Wow, okay.
That is scary. That was this rewash with acetone?
Yeah.
That was my last rewash with acetone.
Okay. That, yeah.
That really lit up.
No. Hmm?
That wasn't rewash with acetone.
No. It wasn't.
Why are they different?
Or did you just right on?
Huh.
Fritz with it over and over and over because it's still a really strong acid.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It will eat polyethylene, so I'm just gonna pour it.
Fascinating.
So that was
1214. Hmm. Fascinating.
It's really not going
through. Yeah, that's interesting.
Well, yeah. This is the only thing we've tested that is entirely in water. And they did say that piranha doesn't eat it.
Other corrosives do, though. Significantly.
Too bad we don't have the swatch of the regular nomads. Too bad we don't have the swatch of the regular
nomads. We could.
They didn't.
We could potentially sacrifice an old lab coat.
Let's not. I mean, we could.
So it's a product.
Well, now.
What's happening? That's legit. Okay.
That's kind of exciting.
Yeah. So we work with strong.
One of them kind of
strong.
It's kind of interesting.
Yeah. I'm verbally enjoying them.
So it's, it is wet.
But it didn't go through the fabric.
Well, it didn't beat up off the fabric either. Can't tell if any moisture got through.
It doesn't look like it.
Yeah, I don't think so. I'm kind of soaked that.
Yeah. Piece of cotton cloth rubber banded directly under the lab coat, simulating, say, a t-shirt.
The intent was to soak the fabric underneath and to see if the blue fabric, Nomex base fabric, will keep the flame off of
a t-shirt fabric company.
We've caught a rubber band.
We've caught a rubber band. Oh, well, there, that'll be.
So this is untreated
sample.
And then this is the sample that was retreated with acetone. And they look to be about the same.
Yeah.
Kind of an unscientific.
The right one, it was really the wrong band.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think that was
Yeah, I think you're right.